Gavin McInnes is a political commentator who is by no means at all a, someone who is an intelligent political commentator in any way, shape, or form, or a very substantive one. And he, however, is someone who has a very big cult of following, just like people like Ben Shapiro and Steven Crowder. But he has a little bit of a different one, a little bit of a deviation. Now, Gavin McInnes has advocated for the complete abolishing of welfare, which is absolutely insane. Absolute insanity by any stretch of the imagination or any means that you would come through from. But what we're going to be looking at here, because I did a video about Gavin McInnes a while ago, and a lot of people are like, oh, why do you hate him, bro? We're going to be looking at this here. It's kind of a flashback video, and you're going to be seeing him going on a ridiculously sexist rant. Check it out.
I think this is sort of God's way. This is nature's way of saying women should be at home with the kids. They're happier there.
I hope that your viewers do not take you, sir, seriously.
There's a great book you should read. It's called Why Men Earn More, and it's all about women choosing to put family over work, and that's why they earn less.
Having a choice does not mean that you're less ambitious, and your comments are absolutely deplorable. Sean, I would like
less
you...
Less ambitious in the workplace.
I would like you to adjust it. You're a father. You have a daughter.
If you were a real feminist, you would support housewives and see them as the heroes,
you
and women who work wasting their time.
You said that women are less ambitious.
Women are
you
less
have
ambitious.
Said, you have also said... that women are better suited in the home.
Yes,
you've
that's
also
a fact.
Said that that women are emotional and women shouldn't run for public office. All of these things that just
I never said women shouldn't run for
yes,
public
you
office.
Yes, you have. You've said
if we're
that
talking
before.
About 50% of the population, generally out of this 250 million people or 150 million people, most women are happier at home. They are pretending that they like working and they're not making money because they don't stay all night at the office. They don't go the extra mile.
Why
they don't
am I
work all
here?
Weekend.
I'm
You're making a mistake.
Here.
You would be much happier at home with a husband and children.
Oh boy. Oh,
I mean,
boy.
I'm literally
You just said you're single.
Oh.
You don't have a boyfriend. You're what?
That's
you're celibate?
My choice.
Yeah, look, you're miserable. You would be so much happier with kids around you tonight. Imagine coming home. Mommy's home.
You know what, Gavin? You're not funny. You're not what you
I'm not
you do not
to be funny.
Do anything.
I'm trying to make you happy.
You do not do anything for the better. Sean, this
yes,
isn't
I do.
Funny.
Feminism has made women miserable. Women were much happier when housewives were glorified.
I had a choice to be married, and I chose not to.
Right,
I have a choice
up.
To have kids.
You made a mistake.
We'll give you the last word. Go ahead.
I think that your guest here is doing a disservice to all of the viewers and doing a disservice to America by saying that women, that I need to be married, that I would be happier
would be
at home.
Happier married.
That you're, what, miserably married? Just because
no, I'm
just
ecstatic.
Having a
I'm
ring
I'm trying
on,
to share my joy. You should see my little
not
two-year-old.
Not everybody he's, has the same life, the life pattern as you, okay?
I know, it's the fall.
And not everybody wants
it's
to marry somebody in a bootleg seersucker suit.
This is why I don't take Gavin McInnes seriously at all. Because his whole mantra and his whole identity is anti-SJW, anti-feminist, and things like that. That's his whole kind of, that's his whole livelihood, essentially. And he's really a crazy person. And as you can see from stuff like that, where you tell a woman to go home because that's better for her than working, you're very clearly a sexist and someone who's not meant to be taken seriously in any way, shape, or form. And Gavin McInnes is someone who is just really what I like to call him. He's essentially another Milo Yiannopoulos, who I guess you could say is slightly less, ridiculous, but he's not really all that much better than Milo. So Gavin McInnes, if you look up to Gavin McInnes and say, oh man, I'm a really big fan of this guy. He's a smart guy. You're crazy because he's not a smart guy by any means at all. No way, no chance. He's not at all. He's just what you would call a troll. The perfect way to describe him, I think, is a provocateur because that's all he does. He just tries to troll people. You know, feminists and SJWs are his, that's kind of his bread and butter. He's not smart in any way, shape, or form. He doesn't know jack shit. And on top of all that, he's a sexist piece of shit. So don't take him seriously. There's probably going to be a lot of backlash from Gavin McInnes cultists, but I don't give a fuck.